Hello guys, welcome to your channel The Indus Flavour. This video is all about how to organize a small fridge. I will share a few techniques which will make your day-to-day life little easier and your fridge will look more organized and spacious. So let's start with the fridge tour. This fridge is of 393 liters. So to make it strain free, I have used these anti-slip fridge liner. You can also use dining table plastic mats. So my fridge is divided into many sections as this is just below the freezer. This is coldest shelf here. On this shelf, I keep my leftover stuff and dairy products as it's very much suitable to take out easily. I've used this glass jug for milk as it occupies very less space. So let's find out what and how I have kept things in our leftover bucket. So I've used some plastic and glass container with lids to keep leftover. By using this kind of storage container, best thing is we can store top of each other and also microwave whenever needed. I'm keeping my leftover bucket at its place and moving on, I'm gonna show you this right side of the corner of the first shelf is all about dairy products. So here I store my all homemade curds, homemade cheese, homemade malai, and middle of the section you can see I have stored the milk in the glass container. I'm storing the milk in this glass container jug as it saves a lot of space. And moving on to our second shelf of the fridge, I have stored my all dips, spreads, sauces, jams in these beautiful containers. And middle of its pickle, you can see this. So left side of the second shelf, there is a one box for miscellaneous sachet and the box for flour and masalas. I'm gonna show you what I put and why I put this in freeze. And there is a bread box. So where I live, there is a humid climate, so I keep my own food items like chickpea and other things which get spoiled very easily if kept outside. So you can see here, you can see it's clearly mentioned here to keep it in cool, dry place away from sunlight. So there are various masalas, pulses, semolina, various flour which have to be kept in fridge. That's the best place in humid climate. So bread, in this bread box I have labeled it like this. In this box I have kept my brown bread and white bread like this. And other box which I have showed you, which is a sachet box, I always keep miscellaneous sachets, you know, whichever I get from McDonald's or pizza flakes sachet or whatever. It's very easy to take it out when it is needed. So yes, my third shelf is all about chopped veggies and dry fruits. As you can see, it is mentioned in label. So at one side, there is a dry fruit corner. Here I have kept my dry fruits in plastic and glass containers. So whosoever opens the fridge, you know, any member of the house can easily locate what dry fruit and which dry fruit is there. So it is very much easily one can see. So that all dry fruits, you know, almonds, pistachios and raisins are at one corner. And then here I have kept my all chopped veggies. I have kept my all veggies in chopped condition in these Ziploc pouches. So whenever I have to cook it, you know, such kind of organizing my fridge has made my cooking very easy and very, very fast. So whenever I have to cook it, I just, you know, take this out, these pouches, and it's just 10 minutes of cooking. So half of the time is saved. When you open this, you will able to find our ginger and garlic. So it's about that. So in this plastic visible container, I have kept my chopped coriander. It has been washed and dried and I have kept like this. So it's very easy when it's needed. So my fourth shelf is all about vegetable and fruits. Here I've kept my vegetable which have to be consumed in a week. And here I have stored my fruits in separate bucket away from veggies. I have kept my fruits washed, dried and ready to consume state. So coming to the freezer,
I have kept one bucket at left side of the freezer which says for ice cream, so I always keep my all ice cream bricks or ice creams there. Middle I have kept my chocolates and right side of the bucket which says for all frozen items. So about this jar, I have kept my breadcrumbs in this. You know, keeping breadcrumbs in freezer, it is very very helpful as you can use it for a very very long time. And the best part about my freezer is that it's not overloaded. You can still add many items. So now coming to the freezer door, I have kept my all spices which I don't, you know, use often. So I have added chili flakes, cocoa powder, baking powder, vanilla flavored custard, you know, all things which I, you know, very rarely use. So still my space is left, you know, you can add many items. So coming to main fridge door, I've stored eggs here. Here are all Yakult drink is here. These are my son's favorite, and whenever he need it, he just open the fridge and he can easily locate it. Here I've kept my all Italian sauces in this multi-storage bucket, and other shelf is all about water, juices and drinks. Still a lot of space is left in my fridge, you can see. So guys, just below the freezer, you can see there is an extra shelf in every almost refrigerator these days. You can store all fresh things here. I stored my butter here in such kind of container. And cheese I have stored here, cheese spread you can store. And also miscellaneous things you can store. As you can see, I have stored this cling film here as it is very easy to open if it is kept in refrigerator. So please don't overstuff your fridge with too many water bottles or soda bottles. If you like to drink chilled water, keep 2-3 bottles in fridge and keep refilling. So as you have seen, my fridge still has a lot of space left. So guys, please let your fridge breathe. So to remove all bad smell from your fridge, you can keep baking soda in one bowl and place it in one corner of your fridge. You can also cut one lemon and place it in one corner of your shelf. So guys, how do you organize your fridge? Please share in comment section, like, share and subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much for